Good morning students, this is class 11, subject chemistry, chapter 7, equilibrium, and this is lecture number 6. In this lecture, we will discuss homework solution of lecture number 4 and lecture number 5. So we will start with question number 8 of NCERT exercise. Question is, reaction between nitrogen and oxygen takes place as follows. Reaction is given. If a mixture of 0.482 moles of nitrogen and 0.933 moles of oxygen is placed in a reaction vessel of volume 10 liter and allowed to form N2O at a temperature for which value of Kc is given, determine the composition of the equilibrium mixture. So first of all, in this question you have to write chemical equation. Okay. Now in this question, number of moles and volume is given. So when number of moles is divided by volume, then we will get concentration. So here, first step is you have to write initial concentration. Okay, now in the question it is mentioned that the mixture of nitrogen and oxygen. Okay, it is placed in the reaction vessel and volume is 10 liter. So this is the initial concentration. So you will write here 0.482 divided by 10 and it is the concentration of nitrogen. And here 0.933 divided by 10, it is the concentration of oxygen. So this is the initial concentration. And initially, there was no product. So here we will write 0. Okay, now at equilibrium point, we will assume here that suppose the concentration of the product is X. Okay, so here we will assume number of moles X. And to convert number of moles into concentration, we will divide it by 10. Because volume is given in the question. Okay. So here we will assume that it is X by 10. Okay. Now how much concentration will be left in the reactant side? So here 0.482 by 10 minus X by 10. Here we will subtract X by 10. Why? Because here number of moles of nitrogen is 2. And here also number of moles of N2O nitrous oxide is also equal to 2. That is why we have subtracted X by 10. So here 0.482 by 10 minus X by 10. So here we will take LCM and we can write this like in this way. Okay. When we'll subtract here, then how you will subtract it? Here number of moles is 1 and here number of moles is 2. Right? So here you will subtract it by X by 2 into 10. Okay. Half of X. Because here there is 2 mole and here there is 1 mole. That is why here when we will subtract 0.933 by 10 minus X by 2 into 10. Okay, then take 10 as LCM. Okay, and solve it like in this way. Now we have to write formula of Kc. Formula of Kc is this. Okay, you can write value of Kc for this reaction. Concentration of product divided by concentration of reactant. And number of moles will go in power. Now, at equilibrium point, this is the concentration. So put these values in this formula and here we are putting the values. Okay. And when you will put the values, then there is calculation. Then you will find out value of X. Okay. After finding out value of X, you will put the value of X here and you will be able to get the concentration of nitrogen, oxygen and nitrous oxide at equilibrium point. Okay. So this is question number 8. Now we will discuss question number 9. So in question number 9, nitric oxide NO reacts with bromine and gives nitrosyl bromide. When 0.087 mole of NO nitric oxide reacts with 0.0437 moles of bromine are mixed in a closed container at constant temperature, 0.0518 mole of NOBr, nitrosyl bromide, is obtained at equilibrium. Determine the composition of the equilibrium mixture. Okay. Listen very carefully. This is number of moles for the NO, nitric oxide and bromine initially. And this is the number of moles for nitrosyl bromide at equilibrium. So how you will write this? First of all, write down equation like in this way. This is the initial number of moles. So here you will write 0.087. In this question, volume is not mentioned, so we will assume that it is 1 liter. Okay, so here 0.087 divided by 1 liter will be the concentration. Now this is the initial concentration. This is also the initial concentration of bromine. Initial concentration of product is equal to 0. Now in the question it is mentioned that this mole of NOBr is obtained at equilibrium. So now we will write in the next line that here you will write at equilibrium, and here you will write 0.0518 concentration is of nitrosyl bromide. Now the question is how much reactant is left. What will be the concentration of reactant? So here 0.087 is the initial concentration. How much concentration of NO is left? So here this much product is formed. So here we will subtract it. Now here, listen, number of moles is equal to 2. And here also number of moles is equal to 2. So you can simply subtract it. 0.087 minus 0.0518. Okay, because number of moles are same. So it will be equal to 0.0352. So this is the concentration at equilibrium point. But when we will find out equilibrium concentration for bromine, the number of moles are not same. Here number of moles is equal to 1. And here number of moles is equal to 2. That means this is completely half of 2. So here how you will subtract it. Okay. Now here 1 mole of bromine formed 0.0518 divided by 2 NOBr. Okay. Because here there is 1 mole of Br2. So here when we will subtract it, then you will divide it by 2. Because this is for 2 moles and this is for 1 mole. So here we will subtract initial concentration of bromine minus amount of product form. But first you have to divide it by 2. Because this is for 2 moles and here bromine is 1 mole. So here minus 0.0518 divided by 2 and it will come equal to 0.0178. Now this is the concentration at equilibrium point. Okay, these three concentration are at equilibrium point. So now we know the concentration at equilibrium point, right? And this is a question, determine the composition of the equilibrium mixture. So this is question number 9 and this is how you will write it. Okay. Now question number 10 is, at 450 Kelvin value of Kp is given for the equilibrium reaction. Okay, this is the equation. What is the value of Kc? So here in this question you have to write down relation between Kp and Kc. Okay, and then you have to find out value of delta Ng. What is formula of delta Ng? Number of moles of product minus number of moles of reactant. So number of moles is equal to, number of moles of product is equal to 2. And here number of moles of reactant is 3. 2 plus 1, 3. So 2 minus 3 is equal to minus 1. So value of delta Ng is minus 1. Okay, this is the value of delta Ng. Now put the value in the formula and you will get value of Kc, because value of Kp is given. Okay, and value of R is 0.083, because here pressure is in bar, temperature is given, 450, everything is given. You just have to put the values. This is question number 10. Now question number 11. A sample of HI hydrogen iodide is placed in a flask at a pressure of 0.2 atmosphere. At equilibrium, partial pressure of HI is 0.04 atmosphere. What is Kp for the given equilibrium? Okay, listen. In this equation, initial pressure is given of hydrogen iodide, that is 0.2. And then pressure at equilibrium is given of hydrogen iodide, that is 0.04. So here, this is how you will write this equation. First of all, you will write the equation like in this way. After that, you will write here initial pressure. Okay, initial pressure is, here you will write 0.2 because it is given in the question. And initial pressure of hydrogen and iodine is 0 because initially there was no product. So here you will write 0. Now in the question it is given that at equilibrium point the pressure is 0.04, right? And at equilibrium point we don't know what is the pressure of hydrogen and I2, that we have to find. So here, now what is the difference here in the initial pressure and pressure at equilibrium of hydrogen iodide? So here we will find out the difference. So 0.2 minus 0.04. So here it is equal to 0.16. Now for 2 moles of HI, the difference between initial pressure and equilibrium pressure is equal to 0.16. Right? At equilibrium point, this is the change in pressure. So at equilibrium point, what is the change in the pressure for hydrogen and iodine? For 2 moles, if the change is 0.16, then for 1 mole, what will be the change? Yes, think about it. For 2 moles, the change in pressure is equal to 0.16. So for 1 mole of hydrogen, what will be the change? Here 0.16 divided by 2 and it will comes equal to 0.08, and here also 0.08. So this is the pressure of hydrogen and iodine at equilibrium point. Okay, so now these three pressure are at equilibrium point. Now we know equilibrium pressure of these three species. So now what we will do, we will put this in the formula. Can you write value of Kp for the, can you write formula of Kp for this equation? So this is a formula, right? Pressure of product divided by pressure of reactant. Now put all the values. When you will put the values, you will be able to get value of Kp. Okay, and this is a question, what is the value of Kp for the given equilibrium? So this is question number 11. Now we will do question number 12. A mixture of 1.57 moles of nitrogen, 1.92 mole of hydrogen and 8.13 moles of NH3 is introduced in a 20 liter reaction vessel at 500 Kelvin. At this temperature, the equilibrium constant Kc for the reaction is given, 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 2. Is this reaction, is it equilibrium? If not, what is the direction of net reaction? Okay, so when reaction is not at equilibrium, then we find out value of Qc, and when reaction is in equilibrium, then we find out value of Kc. Now in question it is asked that is the reaction is in equilibrium. So here we will find out value of Qc because we don't know whether the reaction is in equilibrium or not. So here we will write value of Qc, that means formula of Qc. What is formula of Qc for this equation? Yes, formula is same, concentration of product divided by concentration of reactant, and here number of moles will go in power. Now everything is given in the question. Okay, here 1.57 moles of nitrogen, 1.92 mole of hydrogen and 8.13 moles of ammonia, and volume is also given. So for concentration, you will divide number of moles divided by volume, and here we will put the values. Okay, where there is power, then you will write power, and here you will solve it and find out value of Qc. Value of Qc is this, 2.38 into 10 to the power 3. Now value of Kc is given in the question. This is the value of Kc. Now we have to compare these two values, whether they are same or not. If they are same, that means the reaction is in equilibrium, and if value of Kc and Qc is not same, then you know how you can make the value of Qc equal to Kc. Okay, from the previous lecture. So here Qc is not equals to Kc. Here value of Qc is greater than value of Kc. That means we have to decrease the value of Qc. But in this question it is not asked. In this question, just you have to answer, is this reaction is at equilibrium or not. Okay, so you have to answer that this reaction is not in equilibrium because Qc is greater than Kc. Okay, so this is question number 12. Now question number 13, the equilibrium constant expression for a gas reaction is this, and you have to write a balanced chemical equation corresponding to this expression. So this is the value of Kc, and you have to write chemical equation from this. So you can easily write, formula is concentration of product divided by concentration of reactant. So here this is product and this is reactant, and here power is number of moles. So NH3 O2 will go in product, and NO and H2O will go in reactant, and here 4-6 are number of moles, and here 4-5 are number of moles. Okay, so this is question number 13. Now question number 17. In question number 17, The ester ethyl acetate is formed by the reaction of ethanol and acetic acid, and the equilibrium is represented by, okay, this is the equation, and this is write down here sign of equilibrium, because this reaction is in equilibrium. Now, first part is write the concentration ratio or concentration quotient Q for this reaction. Note that water is not in excess and is not a solvent in this reaction. Okay, so you have to write value of QC for this equation, and it is mentioned that water is not present in the excess. That means you have to write concentration of water also. Okay, so what is the formula of QC? Concentration of product divided by concentration of reactant. So here, this is the value of QC. Okay, now in second part, at 293 Kelvin temperature, if one starts with 1 mole of acetic acid and 0.180 mole of ethanol, then there is 0.171 mole of ethyl acetate in the final equilibrium mixture. Calculate the equilibrium constant. Okay, so here the values, the number of moles are given, okay, and you have to first write down equation. Okay, understand this line. Here initial number of moles of acetic acid and ethanol is given. This is acetic acid, this is ethanol. So here number of moles of acetic acid is given, and this is initial number of moles. Okay, here volume is not given, so we will consider volume equals to 1 liter. Okay, so this is the concentration. So here initial concentration is 1 and here 0.18, and initial concentration of product is equal to 0. Okay, now at equilibrium point, here number of moles of ethyl acetate, this is ethyl acetate, is given, that is equal to 0.171. So here we will write 0.171, okay, and this is at equilibrium point concentration of ethyl acetate. Now concentration of water will be same because number of moles is same. So here concentration of water is also equal to 0.171. Now this is the concentration at equilibrium of product. Then how much concentration of reactant will be left? So here this is initial, so 1 initial concentration, so 1 minus 0.171. Okay, because number of moles is same, so here you can easily subtract it. So 1 minus 0.171 is equal to 0.829. This is the concentration of reactant at equilibrium point. Okay, in the same way here, this is initial concentration and this is a concentration of product at equilibrium point. So you will subtract it and we will get the concentration of reactant at equilibrium point. Okay, so now we know concentration of reactant and product at equilibrium point. Now what we have to do? We have to just put the values in the formula and we will get value of Kc. Okay, so this is the value of Kc. Now third part is, starting with 0.50 moles of ethanol and 1 mole of acetic acid and maintaining it at 293 Kelvin, 0.214 mole of ethyl acetate is found after some time. Has equilibrium been reached? So we know that at equilibrium point value of Kc is this. Okay. So here what we will do? We will find out value of Qc for this reaction. Now here concentration is changed. Okay, initially it is mentioned that ethanol is 0.5 and acetic acid is 1. So here initially there was zero concentration. Okay, so here write down 0.214 and this 0.214 in the next line. Okay, and here you will write 0 and 0 because initially concentration of ethyl acetate in water was 0. Okay, and after some time it is mentioned that 0.214 moles of ethyl acetate is formed. Okay, after some time. So here you will write these two concentrations in the next line. Okay, don't write here. Here you will write 0, 0. Okay, now how much concentration will be left here? So here you will subtract initial concentration minus concentration of the product after some time. So here 1 minus 0.214 is equal to 0.786. Here also you will subtract it. Now we will write down formula of QC. Why we are writing here QC instead of KC? Because we don't know whether the reaction is in equilibrium or not. That is why here QC is mentioned. Formula is same, concentration of product divided by concentration of reactant. Here we cannot neglect H2O because in the question it is mentioned that it is not present in the excess amount. Okay, so here we have to write concentration of water also. Now put the values, and here value of QC is 0.204. Now value of QC is not equals to KC because here you can see that these two values are not same. Okay, so this is question number 17. Now we will do question number 18. Question number 18, a sample of pure PCl5 was introduced into an evacuated vessel at 473 Kelvin. After equilibrium was reached, the concentration of PCl5 was found to be 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 1 moles per liter. If Kc is 8.3 into 10 to the power minus 3, what are the concentration of PCl3 and Cl2 at equilibrium point? Okay. So here you have to write equation first. PCl5 gives PCl3 plus Cl2. So first we will write initial concentration. Now in this question, initial concentration of PCl5 is not given. Here only concentration of PCl5 at equilibrium point is given. So what we will do here? Here we will assume, let's suppose concentration of PCl5 is equal to X. If concentration of PCl5 initially is X, then here it is equal to 0 and here also it is equal to 0. Now at equilibrium point, concentration of PCl5 is equal to 0.05. So here how much product is formed? So here we will subtract initial concentration minus concentration at equilibrium point. That means X minus 0.05 and here also X minus 0.05. Number of moles are same, 1, 1, 1. Okay, now we know that at equilibrium point this is a concentration. So here what we will do, we will write formula of Kc. Value of Kc is given in the question, and here this is a formula of Kc, concentration of product divided by concentration of reactant. Put these values in the formula and find out value of X, and after finding out value of X, put the value here. Okay, and you will be able to find out concentration of PCl3 and Cl2 at equilibrium point and initial concentration of PCl5. Okay, so this is question number 18. Now question number 25, which of the following reaction will get affected by increase in pressure? Also mention whether the reaction will cause the reaction to go to the right or left direction. So here in the first equation, CH4 plus 2 moles of S2 gives CH2 and H2S. All are in gaseous state. And we are talking about change in pressure. And change in pressure is related to number of moles. So here in the reactant side, number of moles is equal to 2 plus 1, 3. And in the product side, 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. That means number of moles of product is equal to number of moles of reactant. Right? So that means this reaction is already in equilibrium, so there will be no change. Okay. In second part, CO2 plus carbon gives carbon monoxide. Now, carbon is in solid state, so we will not count number of moles of carbon. Okay. The reagent which is in solid state, we will not count number of moles because we calculate pressure in the gaseous state because particles are far apart from each other. Okay. So here number of moles of CO2 is equal to 1 and number of moles of CO is 2. That means here number of moles are not same. In the reactant side, number of moles is less and here number of moles is high. Now we are increasing the pressure of the system. If we are increasing the pressure of the system, that means our aim is to decrease it. And here number of moles is less in the reactant side. So the equilibrium will shift in backward direction. Okay. Because here number of moles are less, that means less pressure. And we are increasing the pressure of the system. So we have to do opposite. We have to decrease the pressure. So here equilibrium will shift in backward direction. Okay. Now third part is 4 moles of NH3 reacts with 5 moles of O2 and gives 4 moles of NO and 6 moles of water. All are in gaseous state. So in the reactant side, number of moles is equal to 9. 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. and in the product side, number of moles is equal to 4 plus 6 is equal to 10. Okay, so 9 is not equal to 10. Here pressure is less and here pressure is more. And we are increasing the pressure of the system. So here reaction will shift, equilibrium will shift in backward direction. So in third part also, equilibrium will shift in backward direction. Now fourth part, all are in gaseous state. Here number of moles, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 and here 1. Okay, so in the product side, number of moles are less, so less pressure. And we are increasing the pressure of system, right? So that means here equilibrium will shift in forward direction. So for fourth part, equilibrium will shift in forward direction because in the product side, number of moles are less, less pressure, okay? And we have to do opposite of the change imposed. Now fifth part, here in the reactant side, number of moles is equal to 1 and in the product side, number of moles is equal to 2. Okay, so here pressure is more and here pressure is less. And we are increasing the pressure of the system. So here, equilibrium will shift in backward direction because here pressure is less. So backward reaction for the fifth part. Now for sixth part, calcium carbonate gives calcium oxide and CO2. Now they are in solid state, so we will not consider these two. And here, number of moles in the product is equal to 1 and number of moles in the reactant is equal to 0. So here is less pressure and here there is more pressure. So equilibrium will shift in backward direction because we are increasing the pressure and our aim is to decrease the pressure. So equilibrium will shift in backward direction. Okay, so this is question number 25. Now question number 26. The equilibrium constant for the following reaction is given at temperature 1024 Kelvin. Find the equilibrium pressure for all gases if 10 bar of HPR is introduced into a sealed container at 1024 Kelvin. So here this is the equation and equilibrium constant for this equation is given, that is Kc is given, but here all the species are in gaseous state. So here we will find out value of Kp because we know relation of Kp and Kc. Right, we know relation between Kp and Kc, so we will use this formula and we will find out value of Kp. Now here, what is value of delta Ng? Number of moles of product is 2, number of moles of reactant is also equal to 2, 1 plus 1, 2. So here 2 minus 2 is equal to 0, so here we will put the value and we will get value of Kc. So here Kp is equal to Kc, okay, 1.6 into 10 to the power 5. Now we will write down equation. Now here you can see that initial pressure of HPR is given. But here in the question, the equation which is given in HPR is in product. So it is easy if we reverse the reaction. Okay. If we reverse the reaction, then equation will be this. Okay. Now initial pressure is given in the question 10 bar and initial pressure of hydrogen bromine is equal to 0. So here you will write 0, 0. Now we will assume that pressure of the hydrogen and bromine at equilibrium point is P by 2, P by 2. Okay. So here how much pressure you will subtract from the initial pressure? 10 minus P. You can see here that P by 2 is half of P. And here number of moles are also half of the reactant. Right? Here number of moles is equal to 1 and here number of moles is equal to 2. So it is up to you. If you want to assume pressure P here, then here you can take 2P. Okay, so it is up to you. So here I am taking the pressure P by 2 and here P by 2. So here I have to double the pressure because number of moles is double. So here 10 minus P. Okay, now this is the pressure at equilibrium points. So here we will put the values in the formula. Okay, Kp is equal to pressure of the product minus pressure of the reactant. So here, yes, remember this thing, we have reversed the reaction. So here, value of Kp will also be reversed. It will be inversed. Okay, so it will become 1 by 1.6 into 10 to the power 5. And then you will put the values in the formula and you will be able to find out value of P. Okay, and that will be the pressure at equilibrium point. Now we will do question number 27. Hydrogen gas is obtained from the natural gas by partial oxidation with steam as per following endothermic reaction. So here, write down the expression for Kp for the above reaction. Okay, so you can write value of Kp for the above reaction. This is the expression. Next is, how will the value of Kp and composition of equilibrium mixture be affected by increasing the pressure, increasing the temperature and using a catalyst? Okay, so first part, increasing the pressure. So increasing the pressure here, by increasing the pressure, the number of moles per unit volume will increase. In order to decrease the same, equilibrium gets shifted to the left or in the backward direction. As a result, more of reactant will be formed and value of Kp will decrease. Okay, what is the meaning of it? Here you have to see number of moles in the reactant is equal to 2. And here in the product, number of moles is equal to 4. Here there is more pressure. Here there is less pressure. If you will increase the pressure, then equilibrium will shift in backward direction, because here there is less pressure. Okay. So as a result, more of reactant will be formed. And if more of reactant will be formed, that means value of Kp will decrease, because reactant is in denominator. And if more of reactant is formed, that means value of Kp will decrease. Now, second one is increasing the temperature. Now, this is an endothermic reaction. So, in forward direction, it is endothermic reaction. And in backward direction, it is exothermic reaction. So, if we will increase the temperature, then equilibrium will shift in that direction, which will decrease the temperature. So, in forward direction, temperature is decreased because endothermic reaction is there. So, the direction of the equilibrium will be forward direction. Okay. And as the direction is forward, that means more of product will form. So, that means more of product form, numerator value will be high and value of Kp will increase. Next one is using a catalyst. So, there will be no effect of catalyst on the equilibrium. It will just increase the rate of forward and backward reaction. Okay. It helps in the attainment of the equilibrium. Okay. So, catalyst only speed up the reaction. It will not disturb the equilibrium. So, this is question number 27. So, that's all for today, students. If you have any doubt or queries, you can ask me. Thank you and have a nice day.